rail corridor beneath what is now the Mickelson Trail was built by the Chicago, Burlington, and Quincy Railroad in 1890. That company would later merge with others to form the Burlington Northern. They came up from Nebraska, laying ties and track on a single out-and-back line connecting the Black Hills to their main network. They carved and blasted their way in the straightest practical line between Edgemont in the south and Deadwood in the north.
But right in the center of the hills, they were able to tap the mining and logging, not to mention a lot of the passengers that were coming from Denver, from Chicago and other areas, via passenger service up to Deadwood in the northern hills.
The line was built up and running in less than a year. At some point, it became known as the High Line.
The High Line, the Mickelson Trail now, was kind of unique because it was the one that ran right through the center of the hills, right up the center. There was no denying that the Burlington wanted to get into the hills and they were going to do it in a spectacular way. So if when you're riding or walking the trail these days, you can see a lot of the cuts and everything. And it's really unique up around Mystic in that area where the trestles and the cuts and everything else were literally blasted off of the hillsides.
A trestle north of Edgemont presented a singular test for builders and for train men.
When it was built, it was the largest one on the line. The first few years, the engineers and the conductors and the train crews would always talk about there was just a little bit of shake and a little bit when the wind was blowing. So the engineer or the conductor would sometimes actually get off the train and go ahead of it and just actually walk across the trestle. And then they'd get off back on the engine when they got across because they just were a little bit nervous of it. So about 10 years after it was built, they filled it in. And if you go down on the trail today, you can still see remnants of it underneath on the right-of-way. You can still see one of the old timbers underneath the old fill.
But the glory days of the old High Line didn't last long.
By the 1930s, with the advent of highways and automobiles, the passenger business started fading away. There was still quite a bit of freight going between Edgemont and Deadwood. But by 1949, the two remaining passenger trains, number 141 and 142, which are still steam-powered at that time, were discontinued. But by the 1970s, most of the business was just going up to the Kirk Power Plant, just hauling coal up there for Black Hills Power and Light.
By the time the last regularly scheduled train left Deadwood on November 8, 1983, state leaders in Pierre were already talking about the idea of a recreational trail.
You know, at that point, it was just all just a dream and wouldn't it be nice type of conversation, but it all started back there in 1983.